Think your life is hard? Here we present 9 human abnormalities that are extremely difficult to live with. How these people manage to survive is impressive. Number 9. Harlequin ichthyosis. Ichthyosis is a genetic condition where a person suffers from extremely dry skin, resulting in it being thick and crusty. There are multiple subtypes of the condition, and with a wide range of severity, the worst of it being harlequin type ichthyosis. It has a very low occurrence rate, appearing once in 300,000 births. Many pictures and videos of snake babies with dry scaly skin and bulging red eyes have circulated the internet in recent years. While those images are real, they have nothing to do with snakes, and are in fact the extremely few cases of babies unfortunate enough to be born with harlequin ichthyosis. On top of being covered entirely in a thick armor of white flaky skin, other organs such as the eyes, ears, penis, arms, and legs may be abnormally contracted. Harlequin ichthyosis sufferers live their entire lives in difficulty due to their skin being highly susceptible to slight changes in temperatures and even mild contaminants. Their cracked skin gives easy access to pathogens, which can result in serious and fatal infections. They are forced to manually moisturize their dry skin multiple times a day. Number 8. Ambras Syndrome. Ambras Syndrome, otherwise known as hypertrichosis, is a genetic anomaly which causes people to grow excessive hair all over their body. In extreme cases, the abnormally thick hair even covers up their entire face, giving the condition its other name, werewolf syndrome. Circus freak shows that used to be popular over a century ago used to feature people with werewolf syndrome, showcasing them as freaks of nature, or half animals that were the missing link in human evolution. Juliana Pastrana is a well-known case. She was a 19th century indigenous Mexican woman whose face and body was covered with black hair. Her strange look was accentuated further with her big ears and nose, and she was subjected to cruel and inhumane experiments by the scientific community. Pastrana even gave birth to a baby with the exact same condition as her, although the child survived for only a few days. Extreme hypertrichosis is really rare, and today's records show only around 40 living cases. Number 7. Crouzon Syndrome. Crouzon Syndrome is a medical condition that affects 1 in every 25,000 births, characterized by a premature fusion of the skull bones. This causes the skull to not be able to grow properly, leading to a misshapen head and face. Petero Byakatonda is a boy from a small village in Uganda who suffers from Crouzon Syndrome. In the developed world, the genetic disorder is usually discovered early and treated early on. But for Petero, who lives in a rural place without proper access to healthcare, his case went untreated and became more severe as he grew up. His skull became malformed in a tight cone shape, and his eyeballs bulged out of its sockets. He also had trouble seeing and hearing. Petero's terrible appearance made life difficult for him, as he was shunned away by villagers. A doctor who passed by the village took notice of his condition and brought him to the US to treat him after raising enough funds. Petero underwent months of treatment, where doctors operated on his skull to reconstruct it. Although complications did arise during that time, which caused him to nearly lose his life due to major blood loss, he survived the ordeal and has returned to his village looking like a normal boy. Number 6. Mobius Syndrome. Facial expressions are important for us humans. It shows emotion and helps convey feelings in our daily interactions. This ability to move the muscles beneath the skin of the face should not be taken for granted, as some people are born without such ability. Mobius syndrome is an extremely rare congenital neurological disorder in which the facial muscles are paralyzed. People born with the condition can't show facial expressions, can't move their eyes from side to side, or even close them. In addition to that, they also often have weak chest muscles and suffer limb abnormalities like clubbed feet or missing toes and fingers. Paralysis of the facial muscles makes life difficult, as speech is impaired, and children with Mobius syndrome often have to undergo speech therapy to make themselves understandable. The condition does not impair cognitive thinking, and those who have it are of normal intelligence, but are often perceived as dull due to their blank, uninterested looks and crossed eyes. Social interactions are difficult, as they are often mistaken as rude, unhappy, and unfriendly people. Currently, there is no definite treatment for Mobius syndrome, but it is managed through supportive therapy in accordance with symptoms. Number 5. Ectopia cordis. Ectopia cordis is a condition where a person is born with his or her heart outside their chest, either completely or partially. It is a congenital malformation caused by failure of the front body wall to be formed properly during embryonic life. The heart being exposed is extremely dangerous. Due to its importance, the blood-pumping organ is normally protected with layers upon layers of coating made of muscles, ribs, and tissues. Babies born with ectopia cordis usually don't live long, and some even die in pregnancy. Christopher Wall is the rare exception. Born in 1975, with his heart outside his chest, the man went on to live for over 3 decades, setting a world record for the longest surviving person with ectopia cordis. After birth, he was subjected to multiple surgeries and ended up with his heart inside his chest, albeit with only a thin layer of skin and tissue covering it. He wears a protective breastplate all the time and lives a rather normal and active lifestyle. Number 4. Hutchinson-Gilford progeria syndrome. Hutchinson-Gilford progeria syndrome, or simply referred to as progeria, is a difficult disease to live with. People born with the genetic anomaly will age at an incredibly fast rate compared to others, taking the appearance of an old person even at a young age. They usually only survive up to their teenagers or to their 20s due to old people problems like stroke and heart-related diseases. There is no cure for progeria, and currently all that could be done is to manage the debilitating symptoms to try to improve and prolong the sufferer's life. The most well-known case is probably Sam Burns, an American teen who inspired many with his talks and efforts in raising public awareness about progeria. His TED Talk session, titled My Philosophy for a Happy Life, has been watched by millions and is one of the most viewed TED Talks on the internet. Sam passed away in 2014, at the age of 17, with the appearance of an old man, over 80 years old. Number 3. Congenital insensitivity to pain. Physical pain is something we often take for granted. While we curse and swear over it, the fact is, without pain, we'll end up injuring ourselves all the time without realizing it. This is exactly what happens to people born with congenital insensitivity to pain with anhidrosis, or simply SIPA. SIPA is the result of a mutation in the genes, causing nerve cells that are responsible for transmitting pain signals to be absent. Because of that, those who carry this genetic anomaly are totally insensitive to physical pain throughout their lives. Children growing up with SIPA do all sorts of things that injure themselves, like biting their tongues till they bleed, rolling down the stairs, or dipping their hands in boiling water. Taking care of them is extremely difficult, as they are unaware of their injuries and its consequences. It is normal for them to casually end up with broken bones and infected wounds, which, if left untreated, would eventually lead to death. Number 2. Mermaid Syndrome. In the year 2004, doctors in Peru were shocked with the birth of a girl born with the appearance of a mermaid. The girl, named Milagro Cerón, had both her legs joined together from the ankles all the way up to her groin. Not only that, but her genitals, urinary tract, and lower intestines also shared one single tube. Worst of all, her kidneys were underdeveloped. Milagros was diagnosed with an extremely rare condition known as sirenomelia, or mermaid syndrome. Fortunately for her, she gained attention of medical experts all over the country, who worked hard to keep her alive and to improve her condition through surgery. After years of undergoing multiple operations, Milagros eventually had her two legs separated completely and learned to walk on her own 2 feet. Most sirenomelia patients die within a day or two after birth due to their kidneys not functioning. Milagros is an extremely rare case, as not only has she survived long, she's also currently the only living sirenomelia survivor to have her legs separated surgically. Before her was Tiffany Yorks, a girl born with the same condition, who also had her legs successfully separated and lived to the age of 27, before dying in early 2016. Tiffany holds the record as the longest surviving sirenomelia patient. Number 1. Proteus Syndrome. Proteus Syndrome, also known as Wiedemann Syndrome, is an incredibly rare medical condition that greatly interferes with the lives of those affected by it. Due to a genetic anomaly, it causes skin growth and abnormal bone development, as well as tumors that repeatedly pop up all over the body. Only 120 people worldwide are currently diagnosed with the condition. Mandy Sellers, from UK, was born in 1975 with abnormally large and misshapen legs, and was diagnosed with a rare form of Proteus Mobius Syndrome, her legs continue to grow to extreme sizes, weighing nearly 100 kilograms with a circumference of 1 meter. No shoe sizes were available for her, and she is forced to wear custom-made shoes that cost up to $4,000. She moves around in crutches and a wheelchair, and even has a specially personalized car that is fully hand-controlled. At the age of 28, one of Mandy's legs contracted deep vein thrombosis and then MRSA, forcing doctors to amputate it. Even after the amputation, the remaining stump of her leg kept growing to an enormous size. Another famous case of Proteus syndrome was Joseph Merrick, who lived in the 19th century. He grew up with a deformed bone structure and developed huge lumps all over his body. His bizarre appearance made him a celebrity in the medical world, and he was dubbed the Elephant Man. He died when he accidentally dislocated his neck one night while sleeping due to the weight of his heavy head. This should be a no-brainer, as anyone with common sense would absolutely think tumor upon feeling an unusual lump on their body. But you'd be surprised at the number of people who ignore this obvious symptom until it's too late. Anytime you have a new lump or an old lump that is changing, that is definitely something your doctor should look at.